the podium. Dignitaries, dear students, I am speaking on animal cloning technology status, scope, and awareness. Again, you would be. So animal cloning, in very simple terms, it is an asexual means of reproduction, and in plants it is very much happening. In this we don't need male and female. The right animal which we want to clone, we just need its small tissue, and its one donor cell is sufficient to clone a new organism with the same genetic. So it is a genetic copy of the donor animal, and this is similar, like identical twins, and it has predetermined sex. Means the animal which you want to clone will have the same copy, so it will have already determined sex. So I will not talk about the methods of, one is machine based and one is animal, which requires practice to do these things. But these are some facts about cloning, because one of my purpose is to make the people aware what cloning really is. The clones are not genetically engineered animals. That always remains a confusion among people, that these are genetically engineered, but these are not at all genetically engineered animals. Offsprings of the clones are not clones, and aging is normal in clone animals, that we have seen in buffalo also. Clones and their offspring products are safe for human consumption. This has already been declared by FDA as well as EFSA. Labeling is not required for the clone animal products worldwide. No indication of that clones and their progeny will pose any additional environmental risk, and many countries are using this technique for generation of production of the food animals. And these are some of species which have been cloned already. We have not listed. 11th number is buffalo, which has been cloned in India. And buffalo is the only animal which has been cloned in this country. Some examples that this technology has been adopted. Transova produces about 100 cows every year, and regulatory approvals, I have already told, government of New Zealand, France, and France National Agriculture Research Institute have shown no difference between the meat and milk products of the cloned animals. So this lot of literature supports that these are the normal. Then what is aim of cloning at our place in India? As Dr. Chatta has mentioned, that we are having shortage of good quality animals, shortage of good males and good females, so that we can have a good stock of animals which can produce same or more milk with the limited number of animals. So our purpose is to produce high genetic bulls, because from one bull, as per the calculation you have seen in the earlier presentation, we can get about 1.5 lakh human doses. So if we will clone the bull, we will have more semen of the good quality bulls, and that can be utilized for artificial insemination. So our objectives are the production of multiple clones of allied bulls, improve the success rate, which was existing worldwide about 1 to 5%, but now we are having about 10%, and evaluation of the clone animals, that also part we are doing. So for students, this slide is important. What is required in cloning? We need the good quality animal. Good quality animal, we need small tissue from this. We need to have the cell. Out of these cells, one cell is sufficient to clone the animal. And from the other side, we take the slaughterhouse ovary, and then mature the oocytes, cut the oocytes, remove its nucleus, take two such cytoplasms, and fuse one donor cell between the cytoplasms, and that with the electric current it is fused. And then we get an embryo, which at blastocyst stage is transferred to the animals, and completing the gestation, it gives calf that will be cloned calf. So these are ovaries having the follicles, where from where we aspirate the follicles to get the oocytes. And this is our success, that we have cloned multiple clones from single bull. 7 clones are from one bull, and one is a reclone. These 8 bulls were clones were produced in 2019 and 2020. So this way about the status, that the clones can be produced at our NDRI center also. There are 4 clones already produced, and 4 or 5 pregnancies are existing. So Total about 20 cloned animals are existing in this country. This is a recloned animal, and this one is, was cloned in 2015. This is its reclone. Then people ask, what is the fertility status of these clones? So we checked in vivo as well as in vitro, and we found that all the adult bulls which are available at NDRI and CIRB, they have similar fertility both in vivo and in vitro. Clone calves, we also tested all the clones for their mandatory disease, body weight of the clones, and their growth. In the morning, I was talking, listening some nutrition paper, that 400, 500 gram weight growth is good. So we are getting about 650 grams per day growth in our clone. Those we are maintained very well. We are doing all hematology, biochemistry, and seeing whether they are matching with the age-matched animals or not, and we found that these are all comparable parameters. This is telomere length also we have studied. This is related to aging process, and we also found that the telomere length was also comparable in the age-matched animals. Similar parameters we have studied, and we found that post-harmotility and other parameters of the clone and the in vitro fertility were also similar to non-clone bulls. Also, we have utilized this semen, and we could find that out of 15, 13 animals were pregnant with the Sargorov a clone bull semen. So that shows that in vivo fertility is also excellent. This is the list of pregnant animals at Karnal, some of them have been found. And these are the progenies of the clone bull. Using the clone bull semen, we have produced several progenies. And this is clone bull Sargorov. More than 60 progenies we have already produced at different locations. Another question is answered, that gestation length of the progeny of the clone bull semen, that is also normal, and we have studied it at our CIRB, and we could find that 312 days are the normal gestation with the clone bull semen. So one clone we produced from SME clone that was in field, and that was highlighted on the front science journal on its cover page. So these are three slides on which I really want to focus. We have studied the age of the clone animals that is comparable with the AI board. And India ke andar 12 saal ka clone buffalo abhi hai, jinda hai aur doing well at NDRI. 6 to 7 years, there are several clones, and there are about 10 clones which are 1 to 3 years of age. A genetic disease, sabhi humne check kiya, we could find that there is no genetic problem in any of the clones which are surviving. Parentage verification they are doing for every animal declared clone after parentage verification from the third party. All diseases are tested, and we found that these are disease free. Blood hematology, biochemistry, we have studied. Important things are semen parameters. So we have compared semen parameters, all the things, ejaculate volume, mass, motility, and everything we have studied, and we found comparable to non-clone bulls. In vitro fertility, in vivo fertility, gestation length of the AI born clones, all are comparable or normal than the normal breeding bulls. And cell proliferation rate, their physiology, we have also cultured the cells from the clones, and we could find that the proliferation rate is normal. Multiple clones can be produced, and recloning is also possible. And then, so this way, we, whatsoever 12 things we have studied, and we have found that these are normal. Ethical issue, इसमें जो important बात है वो है, we need to build a societal consensus. Neglect the issue, no ill effect of cloning science to date, but ignoring public sentiments could have effect on commercialization and acceptance of the technology. So one of my objective in this presentation is to make the people aware. ये हम गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से हमारी प्लान है कि दे शुड टेक अप दिस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड यूटिलाइज दिस ह्यूमन इन स्टेट्स वेयर नो क्लोन बुल्स डोनर्स आर बीइंग यूज्ड. सो दिस अचीवमेंट ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग मैक्सिमम नंबर क्लोन्स वाज रिकॉर्डेड इन इंडिया बुक ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स. दिस इज आवर टीम. दिस आर सम अदर एप्रिसिएशंस एंड द नंबर ऑफ पीपल इन्वॉल्वड इन दिस टीम. You Dr. Naresh Shirokari sitting, Dr. Dharmendra, Dr. R.K. Sharma, Dr. Rajesh, Dr. Monika, Shima. Thank you very much.
Priyada, for making a very nice presentation about cloning. And in fact, only two institutions, NRI and NRC, are working on this particular area. So, before I request a response for question, I would like to ask you two things. One is that you told that the average wage gain per day. Around 650.
Yes, yes.
But it's normally around 400 plus.
Normal, we can't say it is normal, but minimum. What?
That depends on what pay of the title you are talking about.
Yeah, yeah. Initially, initially, up to 800, 900 gram growth we see in it. But average, 1 saal tak apne dekhi
ko. So that may be due to management.
Yeah, yeah. They are specially taking care of these that they should not be underfed or.
Yeah, these calves are a bit over pampered.
Yeah,
that's why they take so much good care of them.
Yeah,
they are preferentially fed.
Aur ye 1 saal tak 1 saal ke baad jab paal theek kar rahe hain growth jo hai wo slow ho jati
hai. Second thing I would like to ask that there are a lot of concern and I am happy to see that you are trying to remove those concerns about the problem.
Yes.
And you have studied all these things. But still, that length of kilometers regarding this saving, yeah. Is it was considered as a major problem in Western countries.
Yeah, yeah.
So you are trying to remove that is a very good thing. And I hope that the semen which you are producing would be able to actually that be used by the government. So I would request to the audience to please ask one or two questions from the floor.
If I can add, it's not a question. Whenever a biology breaks a condition, there has to be question. And people are asking.
Yeah.
But I tell you, whatever our group could achieve, it is just fantastic. And we have addressed all the concerns of the public so far. And there has to be a consensus. Having said that, I say the success rate of this technology as of today is not very great. It is about 15%.
But it is for the production of quality goods.
Quality goods.
Quality goods.
Yeah. So having said that, we are tirelessly wanting to increase the success rate. But still, if we can really clone a very high producing food, the cost comes out. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah.
So,